सर प्लीज मेक मी होस्ट, थैंक यू वेरी मच, थैंक यू, प्लीज डू नॉट चेंज, ओके आई विल टेक केयर, ओके. गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टुडेज क्लास. यस गुड मॉर्निंग बच्चों, गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड मॉर्निंग. सो लेट्स सी, आई हैव गॉट मेनी डाउट्स फ्रॉम इन लर्निटी, सो आई विल ट्राई टू सॉल्व एज मेनी एज आई कैन टूडे. यस वेरी गुड, ओके. So homework, I have already told you that tomorrow is the last day for you to submit the homework. First page you can submit, you have already must have submitted, and the second page you can submit till Saturday. Hai na? Okay, chalo, let's start the questions. The first doubt which I'll solve is this one. One by one, I will try to solve as many doubts. Suppose if I have, if some doubts I'm not able to solve today, then you can send those doubts again to me on Learnity. If I have not solved it today, again you can send me, I will solve those. Hai na? Also, in my doubt section where you ask doubts na, there are some doubts which I have shared the other students doubt, hai na? The other students doubts I have also shared, so maybe you will have doubt in those question also, you can check those if I have already solved, hai na? So if I have already solved this some question, then do not ask those doubt again and again, hai na? Okay, chalo. Let's see. Yeah, so this question is sine square theta is equals to x plus y whole square by 4xy. Then you have to find the range, hai na? So you have to find the range of this, or for what value of x for theta this will be. Okay, so let's see. So we know that sine square theta, the sine square theta range will be from greater than equal to 0 and less than equals to 1. Listen very carefully now, hai na? So sine square theta, this is greater than equals to 0 and less than equals to 1, right? Because we have squared, so always positive and less than equals to 1. Okay, now look, let's look at what this is. First is that x plus y whole square by xy, y 4xy. Left side we have a square, left side is equals to we have a square, right? And square value is always positive, square value is always positive. Now see, x and y, if both are positive, if x is greater than 0 and y is greater than 0, then this left side also is greater than 0. That means it's okay. If x is less than 0 and y is less than 0, then also this will be a square positive, and multiplication will also be a square, multiplication will also be positive, then also it is fine. Now suppose if x and y are opposite in sign, that means x is greater than 0 and y is less than 0. Now very carefully, x is greater than 0 and y is less than 0. So what I will do, I will write here x into y. So x into y will be greater than 0. X into y will be greater than 0. This is x into y. X into y, x into y. And this is x into y is less than 0 here, right? So that means this part will be negative, whole thing will be positive, so negative cannot be equals to negative value cannot be equals to positive, so that means this case is not positive. That means x less than x greater than 0 and y less than 0 is not possible, hai na? Next, let's see the opposite sign. So x is less than 0 and y is greater than 0. Again, x into y will be less than 0, so this one will be less than 0, this one will be less than 0, this one will be greater than 0, so total sign will be negative. So left side again negative, right side positive, so that means not possible. So the only possible cases are when x and y are of same sign, or of same sign. So I hope this first part of this question is okay. So this part I hope it is okay. Now let's see. So right now we have x plus y whole square, okay. This x plus y whole square divided by 4xy. So x plus y, which part do you want me to explain? By what I am checking is the right side we have a square. So left side, right side is a square. So right side is positive. I will check whether left side is every time I'm getting positive or not. So when x and y are of same sign, right side and left side both will be positive, and then we can actually compare. We can find a value for which they will be equal. But if left side is negative, right side is positive, then they will never be equal. That means x and y will never be of opposite sign. X and y will never be of opposite sign. Understood? So first thing which we have concluded is that x and y will be of same sign. That means xy will be greater than 0. That means xy will be greater than 0. So this whole thing will be greater than 0. right side is greater than zero, left side is greater than zero. So that means we can now equate. We can now equate both of them. Okay, fine. Okay. Cool. Now next part. See. So this part we have seen. We'll see x plus y whole square. I will expand. X square plus y square plus 2xy divided by 4xy. Now see, here I have 2xy, here I have 4xy. So what I will do, I will try to make 4xy in the numerator also. So to make 4xy, I have to add 2xy and I have to subtract 2xy. So I have to add 2xy, I will add and subtract 2xy in the numerator. Right? So this will not make any difference. Now what I will do, I will combine this and this. So this will become 4xy. This will become 4xy plus x square plus y square minus 2xy divided by 4xy. So this will become, and I will take separately, 4xy divided by 4xy plus x square plus y square minus 2xy divided by 4xy. This will be 1 plus x minus y whole square by 4xy. This is equals to sine square theta. First, till here, I think everything is okay. Till here, everything is okay. Simply, I have just written this in this form. And I have simply written this in this form. Understood? I hope this part is okay for everyone. Okay, so just let me copy this. Fine, I hope this part is okay. That sine of square x, I have written in this form. Now see, sine square x is less than equals to 1. Sine square is less than equals to 1. So that means 1 plus x minus y whole square by 4xy should also be less than equals to 1. By this is equals to sine square, and I'm just replacing this value of sine square with this. I'm just replacing this value of sine square with this. So this is instead of sine square. And this is greater than equal to 0. We know this will be greater than equal to 0. We know this will be greater than equal to 0 because this is 1 plus something square. Right? So this is greater than equal to 0. Right? So that means right side, this part is okay. But this is greater than 0 equal to 0. So I will not write that part. I will just check that this part is less than equals to 1 for what values. Right? So see, 1 plus something x plus x minus y whole square by 4xy is less than 1. So if I will subtract 1 from both sides, I can take 1 here. So this will become x minus y whole square by 4xy is less than equals to 0. Understood? Now see, denominator part is always positive because we have already seen that xy will be greater than 0. So denominator part is greater than 0. Numerator is greater than 0. By the denominator and numerator are greater than 0, and I am saying this whole thing is less than equal to 0, then there is only one possibility left. When x minus y whole square by 4xy is equal to 0, only then this is possible. By I am saying this part is less than equal to 0. According to this, this part is less than equal to 0. But this is always positive. Means this is always either 0 or positive. So that means this part can take only one value, which is equal to 0. Only then we can equate. So if it is equal to 0, by denominator cannot be 0. So if it is equal to 0, that means numerator must be equal to 0. That means x minus y whole square is equal to 0. This means x minus y is equals to 0. That means x is equals to y. Very good. So that means which is correct option? C. Understood? Fine. Just copy this one. Very simple question. Remember the method in which I am solving. Okay. Bacha, because see, why is it less than equals to 1? Because see, sine square theta I am writing, this is equals to sine square theta, na? So from here, sine square theta is this thing. So sine square theta is this thing. So I'm instead of sine square theta, I'm just replacing this part. Okay? Just instead of sine square theta, I have replaced that part. Hai na? Okay. Just copy this one. Then we move on to the next one. रिमेंबर बच्चे फ्रॉम सीकर्स बुक, अश्विन फ्रॉम सीकर्स बुक। अच्छा दिस कंडीशन, ओके फाइन। सी व्हाट द कंडीशन आर दैट वी हैव ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड, भाई ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड आई हैव अ स्क्वायर, ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड आई हैव पॉजिटिव वैल्यू, राइट? सो दिस विल ऑलवेज बी पॉजिटिव, ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड विल ऑलवेज बी पॉजिटिव। सपोज यू हैव एक्स इज इक्वल टू 2 एंड वाई इज इक्वल टू -1, एक्स इज इक्वल टू, और सपोज एक्स इज इक्वल टू, एक्स इज इक्वल टू सपोज or y you can take as -2 and x is equals to 1. Okay, let's take it like this. X is equals to 1 and y is equals to -2. So this part will become 1 minus 2. So 1 whole square. In denominator, you will have -4 into 2. So -8. Now this part on the right side will have minus. And left side we have plus. So they will never be equal. But if left side is plus and right side is minus, they can never equate. So suppose we can never equate -2 is equals to 1. It is not possible. So that is why I'm just trying to check out that for what values of x it is negative. For what condition on x will be negative on the left side. So I know this is positive. This part is greater than 0. Only this part is left. So I know x, y should be greater than 0. That means both should be either positive or both should be negative. Understood? Understood? Ashwati, because sine theta is less than 1 and greater than -1. This equation, this condition I have written many times. Hai na? Last two steps. Okay. Fine. So what this is, this I have taken this on the left side. So this is 1 minus 1 will become 0. So that means x minus y whole square upon 4xy should be less than equal to 0. Less than equal to 0. Now we know that x minus this part is positive. This part is positive, right? This part we have already taken care of. This part is also positive. So when positive upon positive, so total thing is positive. My total thing is positive, right? So if total thing is positive, that means this part can become zero or positive. This part is right side is saying it is less than equal to zero. So the only thing it can match is when it is equals to zero. When it is equals to zero, it will satisfy this condition also. It will satisfy this condition also. So that means left and right both are zero. So that means x minus y whole square by 4xy is zero. This can only be zero when the numerator is zero. So just x is equals to y. Okay, fine. This part is okay. Fine. Chalo, next question. Now solve this one. Okay. बच्चे स्लाइड, व्हाई एम आई शेयरिंग स्लाइड्स विद यू, बिकॉज आई डोंट वांट यू टू कॉपी एवरीथिंग। इफ यू हैव मिस्ड आउट समथिंग देन यू लीव सम पेजेस आफ्टर व्हेन आई हैव गिवन यू द पीडीएफ, यू कैन जस्ट कॉपी द रिमेनिंग पेजेस आफ्टरवर्ड्स, है ना? सो दैट वी विल नॉट वेस्ट टाइम इन कॉपिंग ओनली, है ना? सो आफ्टरवर्ड्स यू ऑलरेडी हैव द पीडीएफ, सो यू कैन जस्ट कॉपी द, यू कैन जस्ट कंप्लीट योर नोट्स आफ्टरवर्ड्स। कैन यू डू दैट? शुड वी मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, बिकॉज वी हैव लिमिटेड टाइम। Okay, chalo. Kaushik, I got your question. I have told you in the first minute also, Kaushik, the first thing which I said, that if I am not able to solve the question, then you send me once again. If by chance I missed your question, then you can send me once again. Also, some question which are repeated, I have solved those question on a particular person and I have sent it to everyone. So I have said that you check those question also. right? The question which you are asking, I have already solved those question and I have sent it many times to other students. And you, those question you will have in your my question doubt, my doubt section. So you can check it once. Okay, Kaushik, will you check it once? Hai na? So you can do one thing. If suppose, again, I'm saying, everything I cannot discuss in 1 hour. We have 1 hour. I cannot discuss this whole world's problem in this 1 hour. So what I can do, I can take limited questions. Hai na? So I've taken a limited question. Maybe I will have those questions also. Maybe I'll have those questions also. 84, 85, I think you were saying. Hai na? So maybe I have those questions also. But if I am not solved, if I am not solved, you can just send those questions once again. Send those question once again and I will solve. You know, if suppose I missed out those question, you can send me once again, I will solve. Don't worry. Okay, so let's solve this one. 2 to the power sine x plus cos x is equals to 1. Now see, here we have 2 to the power sine x plus cos x is equals to 1. This 1 I can write as 2 to the power 0. By this 1 I can write as 2 to the power 0. Right. So that means if I will compare the power, sine x plus cos x is equals to 0. By if I will compare the power, sine x plus cos x should be equals to 0. Sine x plus cos y. I'm sorry. This is sine x cos y. Sine x plus cos y is equals to 1. So that means this is equals to 0. Right. Now, so that means this will be sine x plus cos y is equals to 0. Sine x plus cos y is equals to 0. Right. So that means sine x is equals to minus. I will take this on the other side. So this will become cos of y is equals to minus of sine of x. Right. Minus of sine of x. I can write as sine minus of sine of x in terms of cos y. How will I get minus cos y? So suppose if I'll write cos of pi by 2 plus x. If I will write cos of pi by 2 plus x, then I will get, this will become minus of sine x, right? This will become minus of sine x. So I can substitute this part. So this is cos of y is equals to cos of pi by 2 plus x, right? Understood? So that means what I can say, that this part, this cos of y, so that means y is equals to, y will become, I will write the general solution. So y will become 2n pi plus minus pi by 2 plus x. Okay, 2n pi plus minus pi by 2 plus x. So this is y is equals to 2n pi plus minus pi by 2 plus minus x. So this will be the general solution in terms of y, or if you want to write in terms of x, you can write in terms of x also. Understood? Okay, I hope this part is okay for everyone. Fine. No, bachcha, they have not given y and x are acute. It won't matter because this is a general solution. We do not worry about acute or not acute. For general solution, we are not bothered about acute or not acute. Hai na? How to write in terms of x? Okay. So suppose if you have written, if not taken sine x there. So if you have taken sine x is equals to minus of cos y. Hai na? If you have taken sine x is equals to minus of cos y. So minus cos y, I will try to write in terms of sine x. So suppose sine x is equals to, when will you get minus of cos y? When you will get minus of cos y? So you will have sine of. So that means in first quadrant, it cannot be. In second quadrant, it cannot be. So this will be in fourth quadrant. This will be in fourth or third quadrant, right? So in fourth quadrant, I can write as this is 90. So then I can write as 3 pi by 2 sine of 3 pi by 2 plus suppose sine of 3 pi by 2 plus or minus y. I can write. So sine of 3 pi by 2 plus or minus y. Hai na? Plus y, minus y, anything you can write. Because third and fourth quadrant, both sine is negative. So now we can write x is equals to n pi plus minus 1 to the power n 3 pi by 2 plus y. So this will become x is equals to n pi plus minus 1 to the power n 3 pi by 2 minus 1 to the power n y. Hai na? Both when you will write different values of n, both values when you'll write different values of n, you will get same values of x and y. Both will give you exactly same answer. So I hope this one is okay for everyone. Ha, understood? Fine. Okay. Y minus, हाँ बच्चा y minus pi by 2. Okay, let's see y minus pi by 2. Yes, or you can write that also. Yes. Who asked, who said y minus pi by 2? Yes, that also you can write. You can write here as sine of y minus pi by 2 also. That is also correct. Very good, very good. That is also correct. है ना? Okay. हाँ, cos is positive, but this sine, ना, sine of something in fourth quadrant is negative. है ना? Huh, see, these two are same. When you will write different values of n, when you will write different values of n, you will get different values of, you will get different values of sine and cos. You will get different values of sine and cos, right? So for those values of sine and cos, they should have a relation between them. Sine and cos should have a relation between them. Suppose from here, if suppose I'm getting x plus y is equals, x is equals to 30 degree, then y will come out to be, suppose x I'm writing 30 degree, so y will come out to be minus of 30 degree, or suppose minus of 60 degree, right? So if I'll substitute, so that's what I'm saying, that you will get a, every value of n, you will get a relation between x and y. That x and y, when you substitute, you will get the same. Understood? Fine. Okay. Chalo. Next part. Next part of this is 16 sine square x plus cos square is equals to 4. So let's see. 16 to the power sine square x plus cos square y is equals to 4. So this thing also I can write. Jeffrey, what Google class code? I do not have any Google class code. So don't write same message again and again. Okay. Fine. Okay. So this is 16 power 1 by 2. Yes. So this is basically, either you can write 16 power 1 by 2. Very good, Siddharth. Or you can write, if you are confused that, okay, what power? So you can write as 16. You can write as 4 square, right? 16, we can write 4 square. So I can write this as 4 square sine square x plus cos square y is equals to 4 to the power 1, right? So I can now compare once again. So if I'll compare once again, both will be equal. So this will become 2 into sine square x plus cos square y is equals to 1. So I will simply take it other side. So this is 2 into sine square x plus cos square y is equals to 1 by 2. Right? Now what I can do here, I can convert cos, this is a, we can use a formula. 16s 2 to the power 4. Bacha, phir bhi same aega na. 16 if you'll write as 2 to the power 4. 2 to the power 4 into sine square x plus cos square y is equals to 4. 2 to the power 2. 4 will be 2 to the power 2. Again, if I'll compare. So this is 4 into sine square x plus cos square y is equals to 2. 2 and 2 will get cancelled. So you'll have sine square x plus cos square y is equals to 1 by 2. Same thing we are getting. Right? Right. So both we are getting same equation. So there is no point which way you are writing. Either I can write this way or this way. Right. Somebody has said that, okay, sir, we can write, if one of you have already said that, sir, 4 we can write as 16 to the power 1 by 2. Right. So 16 power sine square x plus cos square y is equals to, this is 4 is what? 16 to the power 1 by 2. So I can compare these also. So if I'll write sine square x plus cos square y is equals to 1 by 2. Even then I am getting the same value. Right? Even then I am getting the same value. Understood? I hope this is okay for everyone. Right? But no matter what you do, if the steps are correct, then you can solve the question. If the steps are correct, then it is fine. If steps are correct, then it is completely fine. I hope this one is okay for everyone. Please tell me, bacho, if this is okay. Yes? Very good, bacho. Very good, very good, very good. Okay? So, now see. Yes. We have sine square x plus cos square y is equals to 1 by 2. Hai na? So what we can do is साइन स्क्वायर एक्स प्लस कॉस स्क्वायर वाई इज इक्वल टू 1/2. इफ यू रिमेंबर साइन स्क्वायर एक्स प्लस कॉस स्क्वायर वाई, वी हैव रिटेन वन फॉर्मुला. इफ यू रिमेंबर, टेल मी व्हाट इज दैट फॉर्मुला. If anyone can tell me, if sine square x plus cos square y is equals to 1 by 2, so 16 can also be written as 2 to the power 4. Haan bachcha, 16 can also be written as 2 to the power 4. I said na, from there also you will get the same value. From there also you will get same value. From there also you will get same value. Hai na? Okay. Now see, even if you do not remember साइन स्क्वायर, हाँ, कॉस ए प्लस बी इंटू कॉस ए माइनस बी. ओके, सो सी, इवन इफ यू डू नॉट रिमेंबर, इवन सपोज इफ यू डू नॉट रिमेंबर, देन यू कैन डू वन थिंग. यू कैन कन्वर्ट दिस कॉस स्क्वायर वाई, यू कैन कन्वर्ट दिस कॉस स्क्वायर वाई इंटू साइन स्क्वायर. है ना, कॉस स्क्वायर वाई इज वन माइनस साइन स्क्वायर एक्स प्लस वन माइनस वन माइनस साइन स्क्वायर वाई इज इक्वल टू 1/2, राइट. सो दिस इज 1/2, right? Somebody has written something else. Sine of a plus b whole square minus 2 sine a cos b. Okay, fine. Okay, but bache, if I'll write in perfect square form na, then what will you do with sine a plus cos b, cos y? Sine a plus cos y. वहाँ पे फिर you will have problem, है ना? है ना? ओके, सो लेट्स सी. सो इफ यू डू नॉट रिमेंबर, सो व्हाट वी कैन डू इज कॉस स्क्वायर वाई वी कैन राइट एज 1 माइनस साइन स्क्वायर वाई. कॉस स्क्वायर वाई वी कैन राइट एज 1 माइनस साइन स्क्वायर वाई इज इक्वल टू 1/2, राइट, इज इक्वल टू 1/2. सो दिस हियर व्हाट वी कैन टेक, आई कैन राइट साइन स्क्वायर एक्स माइनस साइन स्क्वायर वाई इज इक्वल टू माइनस वन बाई टू, राइट. और आई कैन राइट multiply with minus sign so that I will have plus on both sides. So 1/2 is equals to sine square y minus sine square x. I hope this one is okay. So I can write 1/2 is equals to sine y minus sine x into sine y plus sine x. I can write it like this: sine y minus sine x into sine y plus sine x. Now what will this become? 1/2 into sine y minus sine x. Why I don't take cos x plus, because it's sine square x plus cos square x is equals to 1. Sine square x plus cos square y is not equals to 1 always. Hai na, Kaushik, did you understood? Just wait for a second. I'll come back. Understood? So basically what we can do, we can write this. Sir, we can substitute sine x is equals to minus cos y. Because this is not equal to zero, right? So we'll have two solutions from this. You can have two solutions from this, and from there you can solve. You can combine these two, and then you can solve. Understood? Okay. Fine. So just copy this one. You can also use the formula. If you remember, you can also use the formula. Yes. So just copy this one. Yes. Next. So try this one. This is also a simple question. Many of you have asked. So just copy this one also. Try to solve it. Acha, okay. A final answer, I do not remember. It was given in book. Just let me check. Final answer, you can just check the from the book. Hai na? It is given in the book, right? Okay, so I'm just telling you the methods of solving, right? So you can just solve it like this. Fine, you can try it and you can solve. Fine, okay, next, solve this one. Cos of 2 theta is equals to root 2. So see, we'll see, cos of 2 theta is equals to root 2 plus 1, cos of 1 minus 1 by, okay, 1 0, okay, fine. Okay, Ashwin, all the question already solved. By doing, it's okay, bacha, it's okay. Kanish, that is good if you have solved. Hai na? Okay, so this is cos of 2 theta. So cos of 2 theta is equals to root 2 plus 1 into cos of minus 1 by root 2. Okay, now one thing which I can do is here cos of 2 theta I can substitute as means cos of 2 theta because here also I have cos of theta. Here also I have cos of, here I have cos 2 theta. So but first thing which comes to my mind is that I should convert this cos of 2 theta into cos theta form. So this will become cos square theta or 2 cos square theta minus 1 is equals to root 2 plus 1 into cos minus 1 by root 2. By this part is okay for everyone, right? Now what I will do, I will take this 2 and I will divide everything with 2. I will divide everything with 2. So this will become cos square theta minus 1. So this will be 1 by 2 is equals to, this will become root 2 plus 1 by root by 2 into so this will become cos root 2 cos theta minus 1 by 2 root 2. Sorry, this will become, yeah, this will become cos theta minus 1 by root 2. Right, sir, we can use cos 2 theta. Ha, that is what I'm using. Na, cos 2 theta is 2 cos square theta minus 1. So now I'm dividing everywhere with, or even if you want to divide everywhere with, okay, fine. If you don't want to divide, then it's okay. So what you can do, this is okay. Are cos theta likh lo na? I forgot cos theta. Hai na? So this is okay. So what I will do now, I will multiply this root 2 in this cos theta. So this is 2 cos square theta. I will cross multiply this root 2 everywhere. So 2 root 2 into 2, 2 root 2 into 2 minus root 2 is equals to root 2 plus 1 into cos theta minus, this will become 1 into so if I'll cross multiply, so this will become 2 into root 2 cos square theta minus root 2 is equals to root 2 plus 1 into root 2 cos theta, and this will become minus of root 2 plus 1. Okay, fine. So I've just taken root 2 as LCM, so root 2 will get multiplied here and root 2 I will take on the other side, and then I'm just multiplying this root 2 root 2 plus 1 everywhere. Okay, so now this is 2 root 2 cos square theta by, this is something like quadratic expression. This will become quadratic equation and we can find the solution. We can find the solution. This becomes quadratic equation. Right, so this is minus root 2 is equals to root 2 plus 1 into root 2 cos theta minus root 2 minus 1. So minus root 2 and minus root 2 gets cancelled, right? So I will take this on the other side. So this will become 2 root 2 cos square theta. This will become minus, this will become minus 2 plus root 2 cos theta minus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, now this is 2 root 2 cos square theta minus 2 cos theta minus root 2 cos theta plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, so plus 1 equal to 0. Now I will take here 2 common. So 2 common if I'll take, so this 2 cos theta if I'll take common, 2 cos theta. Third step, first, second, third, because I didn't write one step, so that is why you are not able to understand, because I didn't show you how to multiply. Okay, so let me show you how to multiply. Okay, so here we have 2 cos square theta minus 1 is equals to root 2 plus 1 into cos theta minus 1 by root 2, right? So I will take LCM. So this is 2 cos square theta minus 1 is equals to root 2 plus 1 into root 2 cos theta minus 1 by root 2. This part you are able to understand, Siddharth? Devdarshan, you are able to understand? Siddharth, yes, okay. Now see, if I will cross multiply this root 2 on the other side, so this will become root 2 into 2 cos square theta minus 1 is equals to root 2 plus 1 into root 2 cos theta minus 1. Okay. Now this root 2 I'm multiplying inside with both of them. So this will become 2 root 2 cos square theta minus root 2. This will become, this I will multiply with this, this I will multiply with this. So this will become root 2 plus 1 cos theta minus root 2 plus 1. Hai na? So this will become 2 root 2 cos square theta minus root 2 is equals to root 2 into root 2 plus 1 cos theta minus root 2 minus 1. Root 2 and root 2 gets cancelled. So that is why I have written this third step. Now did you understood? This was not that difficult, but just the thing that you don't want to work out. That's it. It was not that difficult, but chalo fine. Okay. So yeah. So now we have just opened this bracket. I've opened this bracket. So from here I can take 2 cos theta common. So this will become root 2 minus 1. And from here I have taken minus 1 common. So this will become root 2. This will become root 2 cos theta. Root 2 cos theta minus 1. From here it will become root 2 cos theta minus 1 equal to 0. So this is 2 cos theta minus 1 into root 2 cos theta minus 1 is equal to 0. So that means this will become either cos theta is equals to 1 by 2 or cos theta is equals to 1 by root 2. Either cos theta is equals to 2, cos theta is equals to 1 by 2, or cos theta is equals to 1 by root 2. So I will write the general solution for both. So for cos theta is equals to 1 by 2. So this is the general solution is 2n pi plus minus 1 by root 2 is pi by 1 by root 2 is pi by 3. Right? And this one will be 1 by root 2 is pi by 4. So 2n pi plus minus pi by 4. Right? So this is equals to x, or this is equals to x. Either this or this. Or sorry, this is theta. Either this or this. Anyone is, if anyone is true, you will get equals to the solution. Okay? So let's copy this. Yes, Ashwin, correct. 2n pi plus minus pi by 4, 2n pi plus minus pi by 3. Yes, correct. Just copy it fast. I have solved 80 is exactly like this. So you can solve. 80 is exactly like this. So you can solve by yourself. Hai na? 86 I have already solved and I have shared with you. 86 I have already solved and I have shared with you. You can just check it. Hai na? Let me see. 92. Okay, fine. I will solve 92 also. Just wait. Okay? Just wait. Fine? Just wait. Yeah. So let's see. So first, solve this one. Tan theta plus 10 theta. Okay. That's a very simple question. Tan theta, tan 2 theta plus tan of 3 theta is equals to zero, right? So what I can say that, so tan of 3 theta, I know is equals to tan of 2 theta plus theta. I can write it like this. Okay. So this will become So tan of 3 theta I can write as tan of 2 theta plus theta. So this I can write as tan of 2 theta. Tan of 2 theta, this is equals to 0. This is equals to 0. So tan of 2 theta plus tan of theta divided by 1 minus tan of 2 theta into tan of theta, right? So what I can do, I can cross multiply. So if I'll cross multiply, so this will become tan of 3 theta minus tan of 3 theta. So from here, yeah, one thing is this, right? The another thing is we can write tan of 2 theta, see, tan of 2 theta, I can write is equals to tan of 3 theta minus theta. So from this, I will check. So tan of theta, so tan of 3 theta minus tan of theta divided by 1 minus tan of 3 theta into tan of theta. Okay. Plus. Okay. So see. So from here, if I will cross multiply, so if I will cross multiply this thing, so this will become tan of 3 theta minus tan of 3 theta, tan of theta into tan of 2 theta is equals to tan of 2 theta plus tan of theta. So from here, I will get minus tan 3 theta, tan theta, tan 2 theta is equals to tan 2 theta plus tan theta minus of tan 3 theta, right? I'm getting it like this. Okay. In the question they have given. Okay, fine. Okay, I will check this one. Just solve this one in meanwhile. Try this one, 84. I will just check. Just, it will come. Okay, just try to solve this one also first. So just try to solve this one. I will check that one, just don't worry. Okay, fine. I'll check. Okay, so let's see, one more method we can do is if I'll substitute simply here. So if let's see, if tan of theta plus tan of 2 theta plus tan of 2 theta plus tan of theta divided by 1 minus tan of 2 theta into tan of theta is equal to 0. So that means if I'll take LCM, this will become tan of theta plus tan of 2 theta minus tan theta, tan 2 theta, tan theta. Okay, fine. We'll get something. Let's see. So tan theta plus tan 2 theta minus theta plus, tan of 3 theta minus theta plus tan of 3 theta is equal to 0. So I will check tan of theta plus tan of 3 theta minus tan of theta upon 1 plus tan 3 theta, tan theta plus tan 3 theta is equal to 0. If I take LCM, this will become tan theta plus tan square theta, tan 3 theta plus tan 3 theta minus tan theta plus tan 3 theta plus tan square 3 theta into tan theta is equals to, and this tan theta and theta will become 0. So we are here, we have tan square theta, tan 3 theta plus tan 3 theta plus tan, okay, so tan 2 tan 3 theta, and then we have tan square 3 theta into tan theta is equals to 0. So I have tan square theta, tan 3 theta, plus tan 3 theta, plus, if I'll take tan 3 theta common, then I will have, okay. So if I'll take tan 3 theta, if I'll take tan 3 theta common from here, so we'll have tan 3 theta, 10 square okay I will check this one I'll check this one don't worry I'll check this one just solve this one first let's see this one I'll just check this one. Meanwhile it will come back don't worry hai na so we'll see this one I'll just check that one we do, let's not waste time on that okay so this is sin 2 theta plus cos 2 theta sin 2 theta plus cos 2 theta right so what I will do sin 2 theta cos 2 theta this will become this I can take cos 3 theta on the other side so this will become sin 2 theta plus is equals to sin 2 theta minus sin 2 theta minus of cos 3 theta is equals to 0 sin 2 theta is equals to cos 3 theta is equals to 0 either I can do this one okay another thing which I can solve is see cos 3 theta will be in terms of cos 3 theta will be in terms of cos will get common out in from cos 3 theta yes sin 2 theta can be converted into 2 sin theta cos theta so from here I will have a cos term common cos theta and here I will have cos theta term common right so let's try to solve in that way so cos 2 theta sin 2 theta I can write as 2 sin theta into cos theta and this will be equals to cos 3 theta will become cos 3 theta is become 4 cos cube theta minus 3 cos theta right this will become this thing right and theta is between 2 pi and greater than 0 right so I think you have to find the number of solution I think you have to find the general okay general solution okay so from here I can take cos theta common from here I have cos theta common so if I'll take cos theta common from here and here so this will become cos theta 2 sin theta so I will take everything on this side so 2 so this is 2 sin theta into cos theta is equals to minus this will become 4 cos cube theta plus 3 cos theta is equals to 0 I'm taking this part whole thing on the other side okay now I will take cos theta common from everywhere so this will become cos theta this will become 2 sin theta this will become minus 4 cos square theta and this will become plus 3 is equal to 0 now we know this is equal to 0 we can find the general solution for that this is the quadratic expression because cos square theta I can convert into sin square theta so we'll get two different general solutions hai na so let's see so cos theta this will become 2 sin theta minus minus 4 into cos square theta I can write as 1 minus sin square theta plus 3 equal to 0 okay so let's see this will become cos theta into and this will become 2 sin theta this will become minus 4 plus 4 sin square theta plus 3 equal to 0 so this is cos theta into this is sin 4 sin square theta 4 sin square theta this is plus 2 sin theta and this is minus 4 plus 3 minus 1 equal to 0 fine so that means we have two part which can be zero first is cos theta is equals to zero or 4 sin theta plus 2 cos sin theta is equals to zero so I will just substitute so cos theta is equals to zero this is case 1 case 2 will be 4 sin square theta plus 2 sin theta minus 1 is equal to zero right so I will see the roots of this the meaning of the condition given I will just check so condition given is I think you have to find the number of roots I guess because condition given will be to find the number of roots between 0 to 2 pi if it is true hai na okay otherwise there is no point fine so let's solve this one first so sin theta is equals to minus 2 plus minus under the root of minus 2 plus minus under the root of b square which is 4 plus 4 into 4 b square minus 4ac minus 4ac is 4 and bc is minus divided by 2a 2 into 4 so this is minus 2 plus minus this is 4 I can take common out so this is 2 so 4 plus 1 5 by 2 into 4 so 2 and 2 gets cancelled so this will become minus 1 plus minus under the root of 5 by 4 is equals to sin theta sir we can eliminate case 1 by divide nahi bacha you cannot divide by cos theta suppose cos theta is 0 if cos theta is 0 then cos theta and cos theta cannot be cancelled out so you will remove this solution altogether bhai cos theta can also be 0 so if you will cancel out cos theta then means cos theta you are taking out completely राइट है ना. ओके सो प्लस माइनस, सो विद माइनस you will have, you can also get, with plus also you can get, so you will get sin theta is plus minus 1 by root minus 1 minus root 5 or minus 1 plus root 5. From here you will have cos theta is equal to 0, that means theta is equals to 2n pi, that means theta is equals to 2n pi. Now let's see how many solution we will get. Let's check. So first thing is cos theta is equals to 2n pi between 0 to 2 pi, so 1 will be 0, 2n plus 1 pi by 2, 2n plus 1 pi by 2, because it is 0. So one, only one solution you will get will be theta will be pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2. The pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2. So from here, from cos theta, I'm getting two solution, pi by 2 or 3 pi by 2. Okay. Now see, our next one is from here again. This is sin x, sin theta is equals to minus 1 plus minus. So we'll have between these two. So this is 0 pi 2 pi. So from plus 1 you will have this, and minus 1 you will have this. So two solution here, two solution here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you'll have total 6 solutions. Two sine theta into cos form. Yes, you can do that also. From there also you will get T6 solution between 0 to 2 pi. From, because if the solution is correct, if the thing which you are doing is correct, then you will get same answer. Understood? So just copy this one. From there also you can get, but here I'm easy, from this part I'm getting it easily, because I know cos theta will get common from here, and cos theta will get given multiple of cos here also, so that is why. So you can find all the solution. It is okay if they have given all the values, then you can find the solution. Six solution, you can get different solution for this one. Hai na? Understood? Just copy this one also. Acha, see. Sine theta is minus 1 plus root 5 by 4. Minus 1. Sine theta is minus 1 plus root 5 by 4. Root 5 is 2 point something. Minus 1. 1 point something divided by 4. So this is true. Right? So sine theta is equals to something positive. You will have two solution between 0 to pi. Okay? Then sine theta is minus 1 minus root 5 by 4. This is greater than minus 1 but less than 1. Right? So again, this part will also give you two solution. This is negative. So this line is y is equals to minus 1 minus root 5 by 4. And this line is y is equals to 1 minus 1 plus root 5 by 4. So from both, you will get two solution. One, two here, two here. And two solution you are getting from here. So total solution, you will get 6. Understood? So just copy this one. Can you explain after taking the value of sine x? Bache, between x is greater than equal to 0 and less than equals to 2 pi. Hai na? So sine x is equals to minus 1 plus minus under the root of 5 divided by 4. This can take two values, minus 1 plus root 5 by 4. Or minus 1 minus root 5 by 4. Hai na? So this, either sin x can be this part or sin x can be this part. Both are valid values for sin x. This will be less than 1. This will be less than 1. This will be less than 1 and greater than minus 1. Okay, so both are valid values. That means this can also be taken. This can also be taken. Let's draw sine curve. 0, pi, 2 pi. Okay, 1 is this thing. Next is this thing, right? So this is these two values, and next is these two values. Okay, one is this, so you will get two solution between 0 to pi for this one. You will get two solution between pi to 2 pi for this one. Okay, two solution for this, two solution for this, and previously cos x is equals to 0, again two solution for this. Understood? So 18 degree, somebody saying it is 18 degree. I do not remember the values of 18 degrees at all. So you can just take an alpha and you know this, it will give six solution. Okay, fine. I hope this part is okay for everyone. Hai na? Okay, so they haven't given a proper question. So how, I think in it they have given this thing. Okay, so I hope this one is okay. I hope this one is okay. So just copy this. Fine. Acha, this one, let's see this one also. Let's try once again. For 2 minutes, I will try once again. Let's see. So we have got, I'll try to convert into sine theta. So we have tan theta. We have tan theta plus tan 2 theta. Plus 10 3 theta. I will try once. Let's see. So if I is equal to 0. So if I'll try to let's see, sine theta upon sine cos theta plus sine 2 theta upon cos 2 theta plus sine 3. Okay. Yes. Cos 3 theta is equal to 0. What I'm doing, this thing is I'm converting into sine and cos, right? So let's see. Let's try to add these two. So this will become sine theta into cos 2 theta plus sine 2 theta into cos theta divided by sine 2 theta into cos theta plus sine 3 theta divided by cos 3 theta is equal to 0. For this is nothing but this is nothing but sine theta cos theta. So this is nothing but tan of 3 theta. This is sine of 3 theta. So this is sine 3 theta. I can take common. So this is cos, so this will become 1 by sine 2 theta cos theta plus 1 by cos 3 theta is equal to 0, because sine theta I'm taking common. So one of the solution can be sine of 3 theta is equal to 0. Second solution can be cos 3 theta plus sine 2 theta cos theta divided by sine 2 theta into cos 3 theta into cos theta. This is sine theta cos 2 theta plus sine 2 theta cos theta. This is this is cos. This is cos of 2 theta plus cos theta. This is cos. Yes. So next is, one thing is sine 3 theta and this is cos. Second part is sine of 3 theta is equals to 0. From this we can take solution. Next is cos of 3 theta plus cos of 2 theta into cos of theta is equal to 0, right? From here, I can convert cos 3 theta as 4 cos cube theta plus 3 cos theta plus, this I can convert as 2 cos square theta minus 1 into cos theta is equal to 0. So from here, I can take cos theta common. So the whole equation will again become in quadratic. So this is cos theta. If I'll take common from whole, so this will become 4 cos square theta plus 3 plus 2 cos square theta minus 1 equal to 0. So this will become cos theta into 4 cos square theta plus 2 cos, 6 cos square theta. 6 cos square theta plus 2 equal to 0. From here you will get one solution. From here you will get solution. And from here you will get general solution. Right? So combining all three you can do. Understood? I hope everybody understood. So using sine and cos you can convert. Okay? Fine. I hope everybody understood. Okay, fine. Ha, there is one tan method also, but I am not able to remember or I am not able to solve it using that. So that is why I just converted into cos and sine. Hai na? Whichever is easy. Hai na? Denominator is cos 3 theta, cos 2 theta. From tan theta, I remember I have solved somewhere in tan theta form, but I am not able to solve it now. So that is why I converted into sine theta and cos theta. Okay, so I'll share the PDF now with you. Just wait, I will tell you. Just wait, I will tell you where I have shared 86 question. Just wait. Okay, I have shared the PDF now with you all. I have shared the PDF with you all. Just wait. I've shared the PDF form with you all. Just wait. So now I'll show you from where you can get. So I hope you are able to see the desktop. I hope you are able to see the desktop. Yes. Are you able to see the desktop? Are you able to see? Yes. Okay. So I'll try to see. Okay. So when you will open your Learnity, when you'll open your Learnity and you will log in. When you'll open your Learnity, when you will log in, right? On here left side, you have my doubts. On here left side, you have my doubts, right? Left side, you have my doubts. You click on my doubts, right? So when you click on my doubts, all the solutions which are all the solution which I have shared with you guys. So suppose this is a girl from 12th class, but see, she has also got 11th class questions. So if I have solved some questions, so 11th class you will get. Sorry, 11th class you will get all the feature doubts. Here you have my doubts. See on the top left, my doubts. Here you have featured doubts. Just on the right side, feature doubts. Do you see? Can you see? In feature doubts, you can see. So here I have given doubt clarification for 86 question. There are many questions which I have given. See, so this question is solved here. Fine. Now everybody understood? Did you understood now everyone? From where to get? Right? So see, many questions I have solved, which you are asking again and again. Which you are asking again and again. Did everybody understood? Fine. See, 100 question I have solved. Then 80, this again I have solved. Then this question, 3 cos x plus 4 cos x, this I have solved. Hai na? So these questions I have solved again and again. So please just check there. If I have solved, I will show you in the featured. If you have not got in featured, sir, but for that, for 86 question, the voice is not like yours. Are ha, it is. Yeah, but it is me only. I know even when I was hearing it by myself, I can hear it a very loud voice. And I do not know why it is getting like that. But it is me only. Believe me, mass question, it is me. Hai na? Fine. So if you want, I can activate your window. Okay, fine. Prasanna, you can just send me message and I will be very happy if you can activate my window because I cannot put any screen share. Hai na? Fine. Okay. Chalo. Okay, take care. Fine. Now I will share the PDF if you have not got. Fine. And please solve the questions. Please solve the question. If you have not solved the question, if not in feature doubts, then you send me. I will solve. Hai na? Please send me the question. I will solve. Don't worry. I have time. I will solve. Okay. Chalo. Take care.